It's time for change.
Nadszedł czas zmiany, przejścia do prawdziwego działania wszechświata. I nadszedł czas, aby zrozumieć, że używamy stanu materii, by osiągnąć poziom zrozumienia duszy człowieka. Teraz rozumiesz, być może, dlaczego Kreator wysłał swoich posłańców w imię tego, co miałeś. To oni przynoszą uszy, aby można było ich użyć, gdy nadejdzie czas Mesjasza. Mogę nauczyć duszę i przesłanie. Nie by się przeciwstawiać, ale poprzez ich zrozumienie, przez tych, którzy stali się Mesjaszami, aby dawać ze swoich dusz, aby ich elewować. Zadanie stało się łatwe. Szkoła jest tutaj i uczniowie są tutaj w oddaniu. Wtedy nie będzie żadnej walki między tym, co nazywają muzułmanami a chrześcijanami. Baranek i lew będą jeść i spać w tym samym gnieździe. Chrześcijanie i muzułmanie będą spać i modlić się w meczecie, w tym samym kościele, w imię ich dusz, nie w imię religii, które są używane do tworzenia tak wielu konfliktów. Dla korzyści tych, którzy byli hiperaktywnymi dziećmi. Nadszedł czas, czas zmian jest tutaj. I jak powiedziałem, moje życzenie jest moim rozkazem. Jeśli pragniesz ujrzeć pokój, droga pokoju jest wyłożona bardzo wyraźnie. To dusza świadomości zbiorowej. Poprzez dawanie stworzy tą pozycję zmiany. Nic innego. W duszy człowieka nie ma długopisu. Jestem pewien, że po wejściu do społeczności uniwersalnej nigdy nie zobaczysz niczego zapisanego, ale równowagę pól duszy egzystencji. Staraj się być na tyle pokornym, aby nie stać się aroganckim w mocy, którą zrozumiałeś i posiadłeś. Inaczej wpadniesz w tą samą ścieżkę kościoła i meczetu. To jest to, co obiecaliśmy i to właśnie dostarczyliśmy. Musimy zrozumieć działanie duszy i musimy zrozumieć, że dusza człowieka jest gwiazdą w kosmosie wszechświata. Jeśli porównamy duszę człowieka i tak wielu nas, 7 miliardów w jednym zbiorze, Ziemia jest jak galaktyka z tak wieloma gwiazdami. Kiedy patrzymy w głąb Wszechświata, widzimy galaktyki z setkami milionów gwiazd. Podobnie jest z planetą Ziemią. Niesie 7 miliardów pięknych gwiazd, które są duszą człowieka. Niesie z sobą duszę tak wielu trylionów zwierząt, roślin i wszystkiego innego. Jeśli więc patrzą ci, którzy nie widzą fizyczności Ziemi, i jej zawartości, co widzą? Widzą galaktykę z wielką ilością pięknych, świecących świateł. Każda według swojej siły. Każda zgodnie ze swoją pozycją. Niemowlę ma piękną duszę, podobnie jak staruszek. Dla tych niefizycznych, którzy nie widzą fizycznego wymiaru tej planety, ale widzą siłę pola, jesteśmy gromadami gwiazd. Ludzka rasa, każda pojedyncza dusza, nikt z daleka nie widzi. To jest dusza rybaka, to jest dusza kosmologa, to jest dusza prezydenta. Wszystkie świecą bez względu na fizyczność. To jest magia. Oto co nowa nauka musi przynieść człowiekowi. Kiedy patrzymy przez naszą duszę, widzimy tylko gwiazdy w innych duszach. I to jest przełom, to jest zrozumienie. Na tym właśnie polegają te wszystkie nauki. Dojście do dojrzałości następnego poziomu, aby zrozumieć daleki kosmos. Wszechświat jest ostrygą dla tych dusz, które służą. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy do wejścia w kosmos. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy, aby stać się częścią uniwersalnej społeczności, która została obiecana. Nigdy nie obiecywałem wam nieba. Zawsze obiecywałem wam elewację człowieka, aby przyłączył się do rodziny. A teraz macie klucz. To wy musicie otworzyć drzwi, aby zrozumieć, że mogę elewować duszę tych ludzi lub milionów innych dusz, że fizyczne życie na tej planecie zmieni się. Wtedy jestem godny bycia częścią społeczności uniwersalnej, by być, aby służyć, aby się rozwijać, by być tam, aby być częścią, że w cyklu życia Wszechświata staje się w byciu częścią, staje się częścią totalności. Kiedy człowiek osiągnie ten punkt, pojawi się nowy wymiar w sile duszy człowieka, który jest poza wyobrażeniem zrozumienia życia fizycznego. To jest brama do otwarcia nowego życia w nowym wymiarze, co jest poza wyobrażeniem tego, co mogliście nazwać nowym początkiem, nowym cyklem, gdzie ten cykl niesie ze sobą źródło stworzenia życia we Wszechświecie i Unikosie. To jest elewacja duszy, aby służyć, stała się kluczem. Nie tron życia fizycznego. Czas jest odpowiedni, nadszedł czas, aby człowiek przeszedł przez ten proces.
Witamy wszystkich bardzo serdecznie na 313 warsztatach poszukiwaczy wiedzy w języku polskim. Dzisiaj mamy niedzielę, 24 listopad 2019 rok i tematem jest kolejny wykład doktora Keshe. Jest to 302 warsztat poszukiwaczy wiedzy i to jest tłumaczenie od 41 minut do godziny 53 minut. W tym jest około 3,5 minuty przerwy technicznej i później mamy od 2 godzin 7 minut do 2 godzin 40 minut. Tak więc zapraszam serdecznie do wysłuchania i obejrzenia, a później według swojego zrozumienia możemy się podzielić wiedzą. Tak więc jeszcze raz zapraszam.
There is something out of line I have to explain to you. Sorry about this, it's just something I forgot to make an announcement. We've been asked by national securities of two nations. As you remember, this is very important for all of us. As you know, we had the red circle. We don't want to mention his name as facts about him published. The officials want us to start with the Keshe Foundation supporters. Whatever, the same way, victims of red circle. They want us to start looking for the children which has gone missing. And this comes on the back of what happened in England. You're finding 32 bodies in a container, and they are trafficking children the same way. We want to alert worldwide how many children this man and the group around him are involved in. We are looking for name of children missing and used and abused by these groups. This is important. As you know, 120,000 pedophile people have been found due to Sterling Case and what we call Red Circle and his team and the traffickers which came with it. Now the national securities are asking Keshe Foundation, can we take it a step further? In the name of the Red Circle, we want you to set up a website, a link somewhere, as is done by the others, for the victims of Red Circle, children. And we want it to be established very fast by whoever you know how to do this on the internet, and start adding the name of the children around the world who are missing and have been abused. This is a request by national organization, because we've done this before and has been successful with the arrest of what we call the guy in America 3-4 years ago, Sterling. Now that the biggest circle, now we are looking for the victims of Red Circle. This is the request by national organizations, national securities, because the network apparently is much bigger than they thought and is controlled by Red Circle. Put his address on the internet, put his place on the internet, and we direct all the parents to him, that he has to answer what has happened to the children. This is a request by major national securities, because we have to siphon this out. More children have gone missing in different way, and he knows where they are. He leads the biggest trafficking of child in the world. The way he brought Sterling into Keshe Foundation, now we realize through national securities that he used and he's using websites to get to children. One of the reasons he was and he wanted to be the webmaster, because a lot of young people were coming to see about the spaceship and space programs, and he was stealing data and selling data. Now we ask all the Keshe Foundation supporters, those of you who are knowing, who know how to play, we want you to set up what is known, facts about gentlemen, Red Circle, and stop putting all the victims, all the children gone missing to him. These are, we want his victims, children, and the establishment of the people. We have to flush this out. They think, they tell us, once we start doing this, after now two bunch of groups of people have found in a big organization, he is, and this organization is responsible for many, many children going missing. Victims of him need to be established. Those who established facts about Red Circle, please establish another one worldwide about him with his name on it, and victims, put the picture of the children who's gone missing. It's the responsibility of the Keshe Foundation to close this gap, that we can move on. And we've been asked to do it, because Keshe Foundation follows run into at least now over 250 million people, and it's our responsibility to protect our children and show how he does. We want his address to be established, his place, and how he operates, and all his victims. You hear about the child missing, put it on. That's one of the victims. They are working literally on the streets, picking children up. in Africa. They're bringing a lot of children from Congo through flights from Congo into Belgium. This is the largest scale apparatus. You will hear soon about it in national newspapers. Please help and set up those of you who set up his facts about him to a second line that his victims are needed to be known. Children who's gone missing with him and establishes that he cannot stay where he is. And secondly, the second supporter we found out is the same police officer who has been working in cases for him. They needed to answer for the children that are going missing and used and abused. I do apologize for this, something which I forgot to explain. I told some of the Keshe Foundation knowledge seekers recently this has come up, and we wanted to announce it last week, but I forgot about it. We want to set up victims of Red Circle, and it's all children. Name and address of children and his name and his address. People have to know where he lives and how he operates, and then the rest of his family, because they are the same. They work as a family, as a group. Establish it and let us get rid of this, what we call the worms of the society. And then I will release to you the name of the national security squad after to do it, because now many of these people, they've got all the criminals. Now we're trying to find out how many children's come missing, and anything you hear, we want to be put in. Going back to the teaching. The understanding of the soul of the man is very important. You have to move away from the matter state. Sorry, I received another message. The securities are online, they were listening, they were waiting for us to announce this one. We announced this later on in the end of the teaching. Please set up this as many and link up together. We want to know the children which has gone missing. They will tell us more information. And Red Circle, through his computer, is controlling all the child trafficking. And there are many victims of him. Now we want the name of the children and his organization. We give you the people who are connected to him, their name and their victims. The national securities will give us more background support. They want to use for the first time Keshe Foundation to help those parents who lost their children or the children been abused. Name of the priest, name of whatever comes up, you know. We want to make a profile of these people, and he's one of the biggest important people in child trafficking in the world. That's why they came to Keshe Foundation, because new sciences, space, attracts a lot of young people. And now I understand securities that they've siphoned after getting most of the, what they call the big fishes. Now we want to understand the victims. Sorry about that. What it comes to understanding of this problem with the soul and energy, now when we speak about the energy of the soul, we have to work with the energy of the universe. We have to work with the understanding of the work of the universe. In the universe, we interact with what we call energy packs. Now that we have developed and step up with to the next level, is that we understood the interaction of the fields of the universe at the strength of our solar system. In a given strain interaction leads to creation of manifestation of the conditions. And in the interaction of that condition with its own environment which created it, leads to manifestation of physicality. If you read book one, it's very much in line, if you never understood it, how the mass is created and how the weight is created. Why the mass of a person is the same across the solar system, but our weight according to interaction with central gravitational point of the manifestation changes. If you understand that the weight and the mass is the same, but same energy, but the same interactions, but in respect to interface between two different fields of interaction. One is constantly with the universal fields and at the higher strength, and one with inertial matter of it. Then you understand you can do the same thing with your, what we call energy systems, to lead to the creation of different dimensions. This is what, when you go to the book number one and read about the weight and the mass, is about. The interaction of the fields of the source with the inertia strength creates the weight in that point, but it doesn't change the, what we call field strength of the center. Where is the difference between the mass and the weight? Change the name. The mass is the soul of the man, the strength of the soul of the man. And the weight is the manifestation of the physicality of that soul in respect to its environment. If you understand this, you can survive anywhere in the universe. Your soul, your physicality, the mass of your body stays the same if you're on this planet, or on the moon, or on the Mars. It's the same, the soul of the man is the mass. Then the interaction of the fields of your soul with the environmental field, the inertia of the position gives you different weight, different manifestation of the strength on the moon, or on the earth, as they have different inertial field strength. If man understands this, man become a man of space, man become a universal dimension, man becomes the position that the physicality has no matter. This is the time when you tap into universal energy and you tap into the universal community. Because the man moves up one step higher. It's us who decides the position and the time of the manifestation. Many men in the past have achieved this. Mankind has to understand the next step in the evolution of energy, the next step in evolution of stepping up to universal community. And as I told you, we start teaching this. For you to understand these teachings, you have to understand the fundamental, what we call the principle of creation, manifestation. And in so many ways, we have to understand these little basic fundamental cornerstones of converting physicality to energy, that you can transfer the energy to any physicality, will happen to the man itself. If you have listened to the teachings in the past years, I always tell you, especially in recent teachings, we emphasize on it that you understand. You started with the matter, molecules. We got more understanding, we called it alloys. When the man understood he can mix the metals together, we made different new molecules. Then, in the recent past, we became nano. We tried to separate them. But with the Keshe Foundation technology being 40, 50, 100 years, according to some people who understand, ahead, we managed to separate that atom into what we call a GANS, which is the energy. And then we use these energies to create any matters. By presence of inertia strength. If you interact with a higher strength, you lead to creation of new souls. This is the difference in the understanding of the man. If you interacted with lower strength, what we call inertia, you lead to manifestation of the physicality. If you interact the same fields of the higher order interaction, you lead to creation of interaction with a higher level condition of universal dimension. This is where from now on mankind has to understand the totality of the process. Can I have a screenshot, please? Can I have the screen, please? Rick?
The whiteboard you want, correct?
Yes. Yep. Yes.
Do you want me to share it, or do you want to share?
I have opened up, I couldn't get in. Thanks very much.
Okay, there we are.
You see, what this is what a lot of governments will come to understand where the Keshe Foundation has to start making the difference. In the present science, one my thicker one, okay. In the present science, we started with the matter. We came to nano in recent past. Now, we come to energy, what we call GANS in the matter state. This energy created in interaction with a different strength field gave us the matter state, the copper and whatever we saw Peter made. Now we went to the lower inertia matter. What you as knowledge seekers understand, we have come to the crossroads of man's development. We go the matter way, or we choose and we go the soul of the universe. Here you created the strength of the matter state and you got copper and zinc. If mankind understand this interaction and create the higher order, we become man of universe. Then in this process, we understand the interaction and in conjunction with the energies of the universe, where and how we will manifest ourselves. The problem with most of mankind and some of the knowledge seekers is they still want to live in this world, but understand about this world cannot be done. As we say in English, it's like a chalk and a cheese. You can use this to reach to this, but from this to come, you have to go through this process again. In most of the times. Now, from today, you understand how we take you into the universal community. The way you made systems to confirm production of materials, now mankind has to understand there is a higher level systems that in instruction will become, instead of matter state, it will become in interaction with the higher order, what we call the universal community. Universal understanding the transformation of higher order energies into confirmation of the existence in a higher level. In some languages, you call it different dimensions. The game of space technology in the condition of space travel, in understanding of it, has taken a new shape from today. This one still needs fueling, this one needs fueling of the universe. We have achieved as knowledge seekers the point of maturity that now we can see both sides. One road lead us to creation of more matter state, one road lead us to understanding of higher order, that in that order we still can create and manifest ourselves, but in that strength. There is nothing wrong with either side, but in that state you want to confirm your manifestation, then you have to understand the field strength of the environment. This is how the dimension of the soul of physicality of the man has decided. Again, as I said, it's like before, we got so much involved in physicality that we saw the birth of a child as a manifestation of the totality of physicality. But what does it come with that child? What does it come at hand? What does it come with the birth of a man's child or a fish? Is a creation, is the creation of new energy, which can live in the dimension of universal level. It's very much, those of you who are a cook, is making the sauce. As the French say, the bouillon. The base that now you made it, you want to make it to a soup, or do you want to make it to a dish? Now you have that base. That's the energy of the soul of the man. Energy within the structure of what we call the energies of the matter state of the higher order, which has no conformation in a physical level. If you understood this, now you understand what the new enhancement technology we put out means. In these enhancement systems, mankind has and will receive a choice. Mankind in this machine, in the presence of his soul, will make a decision. Heal me and get rid of my pains in the dimension of physicality, or I use the system knowing how to interact with it, I become man of the universe. Many, many people, when we go into these machines, will never come back. Once they set the soul, they become the traveler of the universe. Has a soul which is connected with the soul of the universe. You were waiting for your force to get your physicality. I have given you a system which will take your soul to the dimension of the universe. As I told you, I'll open more doors of this enhancement unit. Is not enhance your capacity, is to enhance your soul to understand the dimension of the universe. It gives us a lot of joy. It gives us of governments, and as we were told yesterday, we are the only non-governmental organization which is not connected to one of the five nations of BRIC, which has been allowed to stay in the hotel. And this shows how much the five nations of BRIC trust Keshe Foundation and its work. Everybody else has been moved. The team of Keshe Foundation still stays in the hotel till end of the conference, till we leave. This gives you a lot of confidence that how all leaders, being within distance from us, trust the Foundation. Those of you who understand the gravity of such a position, it gives us a lot of joy. We are not somebody they put out, we are somebody they keep within their trust. And all these people, hundreds of people in the building, they all are the nets, so everybody is using it for their governments, for their national work and the rest of it. Now maybe you understand why we are in Brazil and the time was chosen to be here at this time. It's the souls which they decide, not the man. That has given the Foundation a huge step up to be able to meet in different ways and different conditions with different officials. What is important in these teachings, which we try to bring from now on, is to start showing the man the strength of his knowledge, of his soul, what was hidden from him. By himself, by the choice of the soul of the physicality, not by the choice of the soul of the man. As I said before, for the maturity of the physicality to become independent takes 9 months in the womb of the mother. The maturity of the soul of the man to understand the totality of the work of the universal community takes a little bit longer. And then comes the reality of, do we really need to understand all, or do we know it and we decided to ignore it all? How much have we back again?
You're okay. Mm-hmm. We hear you.
Yes, we're on two channels now. We'll see which one picks up, which one drops out. Now we can go from one to the other. So what is the reality of which one we want to choose? From today, a new gate, a new door, a new understanding of the creation starts. Those of you who wrote, Mr. Keshe has not taught anything new. My God, from now on it's so new that I hope you won't break your leg trying to catch up. We saw with Arizona team, they did everything to understand how create the soul, and many of you have tried it. Now you have to understand how you take the other avenue, the other road. Now you have a choice, mankind has a choice, to live in the dimension of physicality or to live in the dimension of the soul of man, the freedom of the universe. And as you entered, you were developed as the interaction of the fields of the egg and the sperm of the mother and father in the womb of the mother, or in a test tube nowadays, we have changed the test tube for the development of the soul of the man to the enhancement units. Now you understand what is on the table. You could not, mankind for centuries, for thousands of years could not do that. With a new enhancement unit, this becomes the womb, the interaction where the man can release and become part of the universal community by carrying an understanding that he can carry his soul with his physicality in the dimension of manifestation. You remember the movie called, where the guy said, Zoot, beam me up, Scotty. There is no Scotty and no beaming up. Now is elevation of the soul of the man within these systems. Those of you who run into pain, into suffering, and you're tired of the pains of physicality, you're given a choice to take the dimension of the soul, but still exist and be within the realms of the creation, in the dimension of understanding of your own physicality in any dimension in the universe. As I said, the new enhancement unit is the womb for mankind to have a taste, an understanding how easily he can work within the dimension of his souls without the existence of physicality. In the coming time, in some of the units in Arizona, and now in Mexico, and in China, and in Iran, man would enter the system with no chairs, with no beds. It's not a healing station. It's the elevation of the soul of the man station. Now you understand. Prepare to be born in the dimension of the new era. But still, a choice to return to live in the dimension of the physicality of the man. The new enhancement system is not a normal system. I said this to John when we talked about the creation of the soul. Many times I gave indications. With these systems, mankind will move in a direction. In a way, we have created a new transportation system. We'll show you how. These are not portals, these are not whatever you dreamt about. These are the facts that you can elevate your soul. Even to elevate your understanding of your physicality, not necessarily entering another dimension of life in the universe. Mankind, from today, has given a new choice. Come with us, or suffer with yourselves. There is a reason we are in Brazil. There is a reason we are sitting right in the center amongst the world leaders. We are not here to interact with them in the dimension of physicality. We are here to change the soul of the man as they are. You will see the new era has begun, even with the world leaders. Everything looks accidental, but in fact is well planned. We did not know, Keshe Foundation team did not know, that when we arrive in Brazil, there will be a break meeting. And we are moved from one hotel to another to be amongst them. Because the soul had planned for the world leaders and Keshe Foundation, and understanding of Keshe Foundation, what we call knowledge seekers, to enter a new era. Now, mankind has a choice. We have developed the system. And this is what I said to you before, in the past couple of weeks. The universal systems, which are produced by Keshe Foundation, are set to take man into a new dimension in the universe. You will feel it. You will be part of it. And then you understand. Now you say, I have not taught any. Now you understand, you have not listened to many. We inform you as much as we inform the world leaders, the ministers, and you look for the face, we look for the soul. You look for the lower level, we show you the higher level from now on. Try to be part of reality. Try to understand there is a higher level energy, but to get to it, you have to create it, that the beauty of the soul of the man in the presence of the higher energy, it shows itself. It melts the strength of the physicality and shows the beauty of the soul of the man. That's what the new enhancement units are made for. I can solve your problem with your cancer in no time. You don't need many things, but with the new system, and when they are set, when we them around the world, will give every nation the opportunity to become man of the universe. It will not be the exclusivity of one or two, it will not be exclusivity of one nation. When you put a lot of heat into something, as it boils up, initials is more new dimensions, new features, the higher strength. It's very much when you put the sugar in the water. When you heat it up, it melts into it. Now that fire is the increase in the dimension of the strength of the environmental fields, which can interact with the physicality of the sugar and the atmosphere of the system to be the water, for it to melt into it. When you open the door, you get a new product. You get a new dimension. These systems are set to do this. As you know, I'm a very good magician. Which one you want me to hide? Now there is no one hiding. The new enhancement units is the opportunity for mankind to choose. I want to repair the physicality, or I want to keep the physicality in the new dimension of the strength, because the field created within these systems allows you to see the beauty of the universe. It gives you a chance to choose with the full consciousness of the soul of the man, if I want to stay in the dimension of physicality. All you need to do to create a higher level, just as we say, heat it up. See if the physicality of the man will stay with the soul of the man, because the soul of the man, the sugar, the sun, will stay there. Just because you cannot see, doesn't mean you cannot taste the sweetness. Man, the soul of the man, would understand the new operation of what has been done. The beauty of it is, that many, many things has to be done together. Man having the opportunity to become part of the universal community, but the man has the responsibility through his collective soul to raise the soul of the planet. That with it, it helps the other creatures of this planet. Now you understand. There is no world leaders to lead us will lead the mankind to freedom, but our way. When more and more of mankind understand the new totality. One of the reasons we delayed and we put this so far, and now we start releasing it, and even next 2 months, 3 months, we are preparing the humanity, the world leaders for the what to come. It's very simple. We start preparing the souls of mankind. We start preparing the world leaders. We're trying to set up the nations all to be in the same direction. The momentum for taking mankind into a universal community has started, has taken shape by you, knowledge seekers, and nobody else. Understanding different levels of it. None of you, some of you never made a gas, but you understand the knowledge has touched you, and that has already matured the soul. That was the purpose, not just to make the gases. Now you understand what these new systems will bring. What is interesting is how much we choose to accept and how much we choose to deny. What would be the outcome of new condition? What would be the new dimension for mankind? Do we choose to be part of this change? Or do we decide to be part of this totality? Do we choose to be both in the physical dimension or to do the elevation of our soul in any dimension? Do we choose to stay and travel in the dimension of physicality of the man, the spaceship of the man? Or do we choose to go to the higher level and travel with other souls of the universe in their dimension, in their spaceship, in their dimension of traveling the spans of the universe? Does the physicality of the man now become a burden for man to become part of universal community, because this physical status, as we have chosen on this planet, cannot, as a physical dimension, live in a higher order? Do we trust our physicality to be given to the soul, that soul in a coming place in space uses the soul of the physicality to manifest itself in the dimension of the new strength. Now we understand what we are preparing the mankind for. The new systems are not just a system that you can get rid of the cancer or whatever. Many of you will leave the foundation because to face the reality, to be able to take into the new levels of understanding will be very harsh. And in reality, all of you have the systems with you. Many of you, as I explained in the teachings, you look as you have to have a dynamic system like the earth and the sun rotating, you have a dynamic system and God does what you like. But if you look, there is no rotation in the physicality of the body of the man, as I explained in teachings in the past few weeks. But your physicality exists because you have created it instead of what we call dynamic rotational, you have chosen the circulation of the blood in a vertical condition. The blood of the man has replaced the rotation of the system. So, if you understand it in the new systems, in understanding the freedom of the choice of the body of the man, we'll go the same way. We don't see the heart of the man to rotate with so much speed. In the interaction with the field, it tries to show itself as a heartbeat. Is the heartbeat the position of the creation, separation between the physicality and what we call non-physical dimensions, as it switches from one to another? Would mankind, is mankind ready by January to see, to walk into the system and know he has a choice? Or would we choose a new dimension? How many of us will dare to take that step and knowing that we still can come back? You got to realize how to create these conditions. That's what I said in other teachings. We will not teach this to man. When you reach this point of elevation of new dimensional universal level, you will understand the system. It's not easy. It will not be easy for many of mankind's human race to go through this transition. We would love to extend the life to be with our loved ones, but we don't understand that with this new way, we'll live in the soul of the loved ones, not in the dimension of the skin. We enjoy the real truth of their existence, not necessarily in the dimension of physicality of attention, within the structure, within the fields of their lives, mankind will live. There is no fear of an end. It's the beauty of the beginning. A new understanding in being able to deal with the higher strength soul of the man, the lower strength physicality of the man. This is the choice mankind has. From now on. This is the choice you are given. Is not the right, is the choice. Now you have to understand how to create this massive space energy conditions. It is time to move on. It is time for you to enter this new dimension. And in so many ways, the guy said, you haven't taught anything new. I hope this is new enough for you to take you a lifetime of the universe to understand what you've been taught. What it comes to is, how do you interact with this new condition? How do you come into the point that when you leave the soul of physicality in the amalgamation with the soul of the man, you see your children, you see your loved ones, or do they live the same as what you call the dreams? They talk to you, they're in communication with you, you're in communication with them, but they don't see the level of physicality. You become free of the shackles of the physical life of the man. Now you understand what was said. If I tell you how beautiful is the other side without the shackles and the pains of physicality, all will commit suicide to be there. We give you a tool not to commit suicide, but to understand the point of the transition into universal community. It's man's decision from now on to choose. In which dimension, and in which order you want to live in. Would you like to live with the physicality, or would you like to live with the soul, with no dimension? And then, if you understand this, in the next level of the maturity of the soul of the man in the new dimension, man will come to understand there is another level, which is closer and higher. And with that process, as we have shown in many of the teachings, the plasma of the universe does not work expansion outwards. It works on expansion or contraction inwards. In the dimension of physicality, you gain power and become world leader and rich this way. As you move away in the dimension of the soul of man, in the universal dimension, you go this way. That's why the plasma is made up. By gaining more in dimension of the strength field, the more power is gathered inside, where with the dimension of physicality runs away from the man and becomes the death of the man. That's why in the world of dimension of the plasma, man always exists. In the dimension of physicality, as the time and death. We start from here in the dimension of physicality. As the soul is gathered and made, we move this way. In the dimension of physicality, the more we go from the point of the birth, the further the demise become more certain. As we say, we are born to die in the dimension of physicality. In the dimension of the soul of the man, we are born to strengthen. Then you understand why the dimension of physicality will release the soul, because now it's time for it to take the flight of fancy to see and reach in a step by step to the point of the strength of his creator. Now we move to a higher level of understanding of the totality. And collectively, mankind is ready for this. It's just showing the path. The new systems, new technologies to be released. And then we choose if we want to be the farmer on this planet, or travelers in the dimension of the universe. And this is what I said, mankind has not reached the critical mass. There are so many can live, and there are enough here to keep the structure of present society open and running the way it has done. Many of you who take in the dimension of the soul would try to come back and encourage your loved ones to take the same path, and some of them will do. Some of you will decide to come back and stay in the dimension of physicality for the time of separation chosen by a random block. which way the man will take this journey from now. On that he knows is his choice. So could I mean that you can free the man from this dimension of physicality, dimension of soul. Then you will understand. Part of the work of the universe was hidden in the knowledge of Tesla. But man went for the dimension of physicality of the knowledge and understanding this is the path to universal community. The process of interaction of the fields in the dimension of social structure of the soul of the man in the universe will become part of the teachings of the future. That when you enter the dimension of what we call non-physicality, how do you react? As we say, to learn which hand you hold a fork and which hand you hold a spoon, and which hand you use a fork with, and how you put and where you put your physicality, in what position, if you need to, and everything else which goes with the new life in the universal condition and space. The choice is for mankind. Now we have shown you the way. Mankind has to decide. I go through the soul, and through it I educate the other souls that I stop the criminality, the hunger, the dimension of physicality, that those who stay behind or would like to carry on with the same existence will enjoy it. But don't forget, every dimension has its own story. And if you get it wrong, it's not all milk and honey. Through the new understanding and development of these new technologies, we open the door for mankind to another system of traveling the spans of the universe. Now you understand, going back to very first teachings, and I repeat it many times, about you're the last man standing. It's you in that system, and it's you would just soul
Sorry, you're breaking up, Mr. Keshe. You said it's you in that system, and we couldn't hear after that. It's you in that system. Hello, Mr. Keshe, we're not able to hear you right now. Hello, Mr. Keshe.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we hear you now. You last part we heard was it's you in the system, I think you said.
I said you in the system. Will decide in which path you want to take. You want to take the path of physicality, or you want to take the path of the universal community. You're the last man standing. You stand on your own in the systems. You stand on your own in the system of the universe. Then you have to decide which way you're going to go. Do I rely on the dimension of physicality of the vision of seeing, or do I rely on a vision, understanding of seeing the universe? So, with these systems, with these new technologies, and the new technology release more and more, you understand that you are the last man. And you're totally on your own in the system. In the future, we develop technologies, systems, that families can take the trip together. When they are in totality, uniform, and they take that trip together to become part of the passages of the universe. Any questions?
Okay, thank you, Mr. Keshe. I'll remind the attendees you can put your hand up and we can allow you to speak.
I love the way you repeat this every time. I would like to put your hands up. How are we going to put the hands of the soul up?
Well, that's... I'm sure you recognize when they do. Okay, so attendees can put your soul hand up if you wish.
I'll be see if the soul of Mr. Kramman can recognize.
We did have a question from Stefania, the UC Italian, in the chat, who asks, Why, when we die, the physicality doesn't melt as we get elevated, like the sugar in the hot water?
We died, the physicality doesn't melt because it's at the strength of the planet where we are. Physical body is created by the interaction of fields, so that's connection with the strength of it. Now I wonder how many of you will start understanding the point of trust. How many of you were waiting for a spaceship? Now you understand the spaceship is here. It's you have decided where I'm going to captain this soul. How far would mankind trust his own soul to take the next step? Any other question? Are you there, Mr. Clement?
Yes, I'm examining our questions here. There's a question from Freed in the live stream who asks, is it not one of the functions of the material world to understand the universe through physicality, meaning that the present limitations are a wonderful teacher, which no longer exists then?
That has been the dilemma for the man for beginning of the times. It's for you to decide and for you to understand your own dimension. You cannot teach it to somebody else. I was explaining to somebody recently, you cannot pilot a plane, but you let others build a plane and put a pilot in it and take it to the destination. Mankind could not find a pilot, a system to get itself out of the shackles of this planet. Keshe Foundation has built that craft. But this time, the pilot of your soul is you. We create a runway, and we create, make available the system for your soul. It's understanding what the technology is, understanding what the knowledge is, understanding that no man has the power and superiority on the other one.
We have some
other things, they came And they serve their way to elevate the soul of the man in different ways. And then they thought they became the center and they walked out. But it hasn't stopped a lot of people joining it. Yes, if you set it up, we promote it. We will come through a new system of teaching and promotion that even in the new teachings, which starts from January in KFSSI, language transfer is done. Now you have the capability on the Telegram to instantaneously translate into languages which you are in. When you speak to the to Bulgarians, in Bulgarian, in your teaching, in Keshe Foundation, or Keshe Brazil, or Keshe Foundation, what do you call, whatever language, or English, or French, you can instantaneously translate it. So, you don't need to be in one language only. You can start cross-working together. This is needed for when we start in January. You could be an electrical engineer, you are interested in development of certain part of the space or system. Then there is another guy in Brazil, another guy in China. Now you have a position in Telegram to instantaneously translate. We are opening these new channels of what you call Telegram, that you can talk to each other. There is no language barrier. You don't need to go to translate. You ask it to which languages you want it to be translated to. We have to bring all the Keshe Foundation knowledge seekers together. And we've seen in discussions in past 48 hours in Brazil, that I don't speak from me, from Keshe Foundation. The Keshe Foundation in Brazil, many of them are ready to start merging to the government scientific organizations to teach them, to go with them, and government is happy, they are here, they are us. It's not Keshe Foundation from Holland or Keshe Foundation from Austria. Now, it's Keshe Foundation, Brazilian teaching their own nation. And when the government see they are in such a strength in your nation, they work with you. They work with the foundation. We passed through the many, many barriers. It took a long time to set things up. And this is not the end. We see more and more of it. I can see in next 12 months, 2 years, education of the Keshe Foundation by the knowledge seekers in the schools, in universities. Because the government has realized, they've come to understand, this knowledge cannot wait another 40 years to come by the guy, the mother teaches the son. They will teach in the schools. We saw this happening gradually in China. And now we see it in other positions which we are coming to. We have to start understanding, we taught many of you. There is so many knowledge seekers that we call upon you the way we have called upon the knowledge seekers of the Brazil. Brazilian knowledge seekers is a very clear indication. We are meeting tomorrow night in the channel you've all been informed of for the Brazilian knowledge seekers. You have to start gathering together those of you who are on the medical and other parts, everything that in merging the Keshe Foundation into the structure and with the government of Brazil, as is happening now, you know it. It's you who have to do it with the government. We have opened the doors, and we open the doors to more and more, because now the governments, we put it on the table very clearly. You can go with the line of the Belgian government and all the fake things that started, or you can choose, because they still were trying to colonize you. And governments are seeing right through it. With the research, with the development, your own scientists, you sit with us speaking to your government, not us. You are from Bulgaria, you're whatever, from Russia, from China. When we start negotiation with the governments, it's not us, we open the door. It's you who have to walk them through it. You have to teach the knowledge seekers. You have to teach the world, what they call your national scientists. It'll be a lot of resistance for a lot of PhDs, but the reason having number of PhD scientists with you, when you meet these people, changes the position. Yesterday, we sat around the table and everybody was a doctor. I think I was the lowest educated man as an engineer. And I said, this room is full of sick people. Well, they're all doctors, one in medicine, one in law, one in something else. And because you all carry this fancy word in front of you, you're intelligent. If these intelligent people, doctors, understood it, I better look, I understand it as well. So I agree with it because they've tested it. Otherwise, I look like a fool. We are not going with knowledge seekers who somebody misses. So we are going with doctor so-and-so, we're going with professor so-and-so. Because you knowledge seekers have, a lot of you are educated. When you come in with us to a minister and you're doctors and professors, a senior minister or advisor, if he looks down these people and they are practicing it, I am low, I better look good. So I help it to go further. I know what I'm doing and this is part of it. Bulgaria is very big, Keshe Foundation. You got scattered because they scattered you. It was part of the Red Circle. You don't understand how we came to Bulgaria. You got played. Not only with your teaching, not only with your children, not only with the foundation, this man has messed everything up everywhere. What was well planted by the Belgians inside the foundation to destroy everything. And Bulgaria was one of the first victims. Gathered together, I come to your teachings, I teach you, I have started those who know in the past 2-3 weeks since I've come back from China to go into private teachings. I spent a long time with one group last week, 2 weeks ago. I come in, I educate. It's not just, you don't have to be English, you have your translators. Invite us, we look, we can, we come in. I teach in any language. We had to do a lot of work to build home. The home is built, now we need to decorate it to show beauty. Bulgarians, we were with the Germans a few weeks ago. We go to the French, we go anywhere. You invite us, we come to the Spanish. Because, as you know, Caroline follows all of you. She's quite aware, and the other knowledge seekers do the same. So, invite us, we come in, set up your groups. What happened to the English knowledge seekers that they can speak English and develop? Just because the knowledge seekers here, they come and listen to English, what happened to the others? Set it up. We are here to help, to support. Now we have that freedom. I have to do a lot of things. It's very much, I was explaining, it's like a father trying to bring everything that the party is ready. It's him who goes and does the shopping, decorate the house, make the furniture, everything is ready. We done all that. Now we come home, let's have a party together, let's share the knowledge. And the KFSSI from January becomes that way, that you open your eyes into a new dimension of teaching. And nobody should teach more than, or be part of, to lead more than one or two sessions. These long-term months and months, and they suddenly glorifying themselves, have to finish. Because 360 people, one person each time has to be the moderator to learn, to teach. Because now you 316, what do they call, Portuguese, you become 360 teachers for your nation. The same with others. It cannot be dominated by one person and then taken to ransom. We saw that in French. We saw how they came in Germany and they thought they decimated. Foundation is much bigger than this. Now we see in Portuguese, one man thinks was the end of the world writing whatever he liked, let them write. In 4 weeks' time, in 2 weeks, even next week, nobody will remember his name. You have to understand how we were not aware of and how we all got played with for a few years by Red Circle. They were well penetrated, infiltrated the Gate Foundation structure, and they were seeing how to stop everything. And it's true how to do, how to increase your knowledge by sharing it not just with the Bulgarians. Go into the Brazil chat room, go into French chat room, go into Spanish, go into German. You learn from all of them. They all have their own beauties. And ask, can somebody translate for me to English? They are there, they translate in the background for you. Knowledge does not come by English language. Knowledge comes by the soul of the man. So, this is how now KFSI has to be used. We are moving up. And at the same time, the start, there was a question, how are we going to do KFSI in the new term? Nothing. You come in the classroom, doesn't matter what language you speak, is an instantaneous transition, use it, teach each other, bring your ideas, and the classes run in different languages at the same time, in the same class. You just need to put, you don't understand it, write your thoughts in the, what do you call, go to the Spanish and write it in English, it translates for me to Spanish, I can read it and then I can answer you. The way we are structuring now the research and development, that it means you as knowledge seekers, now you decide who is going to be heading, who's going to be leading, and only can be in research and development. Not sitting there waffling about how to make ganses, whatever. You might learn something, you might have to learn how to make new ganses. Now, start learning how to manipulate energies. You have everything, you did all the preparation, it's a kitchen, huh? You made the tomatoes, you made the potatoes, you made the rice, you made the meat, everything is ready. Now, it's putting it together, that flame to bring it together is the plasma strength, and start mixing it. It doesn't have to move to have life. If you put enough fields next to each other, they create their own lives to start moving. Depends what you're expecting from the system you build. What you want. What you see, and what is the expectation from what you're setting up. In your teaching, in your KFSI, this side, in January, we want to understand how to access the energy which makes carbon. Somebody's microphone is open. Together, work towards it, build a system, bring the understandings, and then build on it. And if you have a problem, there is somebody called somewhere who can give you some And then if you don't go to somewhere that you cannot get some, there is somebody called the cash somewhere. If you can get somehow to it, it can be done. There should not be any more barrier people lying to you. You know, we found out in Brazil that everybody told, I'm the only one who speaks Mr. Cash, nobody can talk except me, and glorifying and controlling and bringing a lot of pain to the community. Now they realize anybody can talk to Cash, and Cash sits in a member of the Brazilian chat room. You want a question, if I see it, I'll talk. I pick, but I don't want to spend all the time chat rooms being there. I'm not a chat show. We're a scientist, we're developing a lot of things on.
Yeah, thank you, Mr. Cash. Can I ask you one more question? Next week, I will meet with some investors. Hopefully, they will buy the Health Universal Unit. Can you tell me more specific about how many doctors we need? Nearly what kind of disease will cure? Because they will ask me that kind of question. Thank you very much.
Just one second. I have to answer emergency somewhere. Just one second, please.
Okay,
can you repeat that, please? Sorry, I run many hats and something came up very emergency. I had to take it.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.
Okay, Karen, repeat that, please.
The next week, I will meet with some investors so I can talk about the Universal Health Unit. And they will ask me a few questions, what disease can cure and how many doctors we need to sustain the operation and some more information that I can know to talk to the investors.
It's a very simple way. You find investors, you need doctors, you need nurses, you need physiotherapists. Everything is calculated. When you speak seriously, we don't put these things out, that the investors can see there what are they to for making profit. The structure of investment is very simple. The units are 150,000 till January of this year. After January, it goes to 500,000. In cases Cash Foundation sees the position, Cash Foundation will support some of it financially. When we support financially, we take control 51%. That is, just one second, I have to solve this problem first. Then we support the Keshe Foundation team in the way we'll support, and we are, as the reason actually I keep on going up, because in one of the researchers, a team of researchers, we want to move, and there is a discussion how to move the researchers into a new position. The process is that we come in, if they want to finance half, we what they call it, part, we finance the other part. We take our half of the responsibility for what they call educating your doctors and everybody else. And this is a joint collaboration. As we've seen now in Arizona with 10 units in collaboration, now in Brazil with 20 units collaboration, we set up structures. By end of this month, we announced more cells like this, 10, 20 units in different locations around the world. And then in this process, we teach people. Your investors should know, this is not just buying a system. This system gets troubled. This is the process that will support the whole. And then it's a long-term work. It's for till the machines and more things go through. Now, we're talking the same way with Americans and now with Brazilians. The people who start with us now, like with 20 units, and we are investing into the building of the center in what do you call Brazil. And now we're informed the government officials that we are in that process to do. Then these people who come to with us at the beginning, they become the people that opening other centers around the country. It's not one system, one cell. In the Brazil conference, we noticed there are some 70 investors, individuals have put, they can put $1,000 or $2,000 each to buy a system. We said, okay, you come up with what you can between you 70, and the foundation comes with others. And then we have started offering a very simple system. You take two, we put one. So the system becomes three. And you start a, what we call a center, a health center. It's different ways to do it. And people say, oh, you've done this with them. No, we don't. It doesn't make a key just because you got 50%. We look at every case. We are not looking for one to buy a machine and try to run with it. We try to structure health centers. Now we see big investors are prepared. I'll announce in next few days an operational center with a 100 units is in discussion. The governments are seeing what is coming. The investors are seeing that a lot of investors don't want to pay the $500,000. And $500,000 is an introductory that knowledge seekers could get in, and we are going through. We have a discussion. I have to finish this. We go through the same process. of supporting you. We want this to be spread across the world. In Bulgaria, if your investors wants to do 2, 3, 4, we look, we make a suggestion. How foundation can become partner in expanding the technology. We are literally running out of production. We are moving into March, April back until we can increase the production to 1,000, 2,000 a month. It has this new system has touched many. I don't even disclose to people what we are negotiating and where, because the contractual agreements, the payments, everything is start moving on. It took a few weeks for people to understand. A lot of people would like to have the system, but are looking how to do it. Try to do your basic work and then come to Keshe Foundation to the where the form is, where the application form is, fill it in. Go to the Keshe Foundation, go to the shop, go to the Austrian. Our people have made this so difficult. This unit should be right on the top. You come into the Keshe Foundation, you hit it. Now it's a maze to find it. Our webmaster has to move it right on the top. You come in, the first thing you see should be the system, how to order the new system. And then just fill it in and tell them these are the monies we have. Yes, and then we support you. We support you with doctors. We train doctors to be ready for the time you receive the system. My priority at the moment is Beijing, Tehran, Arizona, Mexico now comes in line. We are talking about 10, 20 units per system. We might announce very soon two more locations. We still supply those who bought one or two units in United Kingdom, in Germany. We most probably announced the opening of center in Strasbourg, Salzburg, in Austria, if everything goes according to the plan. We have the same condition now with 2 or 3 other countries. We just try to negotiate, and as it comes forward, we train you, your investors, you want to invest, and the way we have priced the charges you have to do, which is very, very cheap for what it does, your capital return is in 24 months, 36 months, but at the same time you're still making some. If you are there in it for the profit, a lot of groups want to just be there that they can help, but they understand there is operational cost. Every way we can support you to bring this technology to be used by your nationals is there. You got to realize now that the data is coming up and the governments are looking at it, governments have the finances ready to go. The governments will finance, because they cannot support huge amount for Alzheimer's, for Parkinson people for years. This brings a line to it, finish, next step. This technology just wants here. Just 1 second, please. We are there to help you. Go to the website with your investors, or I see a lot of people are putting, we want to do, we are a small investors, we can do this, we want to buy unit. Just go on a website, sign in, and on the application form, say this is it, we look at it, it tells you, just you, because you placed the order, it doesn't mean till you pay, it doesn't come into operation, but you can put your conditions, this is what we have, we tell you yes or no, or we see a solution rather. My priority is to expand this huge centers, big centers, at the same time support the individual groups that they can become. We can always find a way to negotiate.
Thank you very much, Mr. Keshe.
Thank you very much. Do you want to show the video of the new video of the same system? Do you have it available? I think it's been posted to you on the YouTube.
It was also uploaded to the usual place.
Would you like to play it, Flint or Rick?
Yeah, I'll pull it up here.
The new one. We are updating this video as we go along. And you will see the development further and further, and how it is. The patient goes for a MRI, hopefully next week, and doctors can scientifically see the difference. What has happened physically on the brain? Has been any changes or no? Or what has changed? But from what we see, there has been a lot of changes, and these changes can only come from the repositioning of the brain. We know, for example, that because of, if you notice in his standing, his head is turned to one side because of the twisting of, or movement of the brain, and this movement has been putting pressure on the inner ear. That's why he always stands up with his eyes closed, he's dizzy. You see it in all the movies, they try to get him to close his eyes and open his eyes, and he stops when he has that position. Now that we asked them to take him to ear specialist this week, and as they took him in, and we see his head standing up, up to July before he joined us, because of the pressure on the inner ear with the movement of the brain, there was like infection and inflammation and water in the ear continuously, because that's a feature of it when the brain moves. Now they don't find any inflammation, no water and no infection, which means the pressure on the brain has been taken off on the ear, inner ear, which is significant. This now we have report from the surgeons, from the doctors in China. So we have shown the brain has gone, is going back to its position, it's taken the pressure off the inner ear. We see more balance, but the dizziness is there. In next 2 or 3 weeks, he'll go better and upright. So we have the first doctor's report, which is in our position, that this has taken place, that the brain has moved, because the pressure on the inner ear, and as I said, the inflammation, infection, has gone totally. It's not reduced, it's totally gone. And that's, he joined us since we started 10 weeks ago in August, September. Now where we are, we can see there is a change. And the most important part is that when they compare the two MRIs and we see how much we developed, where we developed, and what in next 4 weeks, 5 weeks of the research left, we can do to bring totality. And this is what we were looking for, confirmation of technology. Now that we have reached an agreement and clinical trials is about to start with the new systems, then we show more in different. This case is one of the most severe cases I have seen with the Parkinson. When you look at the MRI, there are pieces of brain totally not there. I can release and you see the brain. If you've never seen the brain of a Parkinson patient, you will see it. Damage is extensive with this case. Is one of the worst cases I have seen for nearly maybe 10 years. And we still have managed to change it. The easier ones, you just see them after 3-4 weeks, they change. And when I looked at the MRI of this person, that to advise the doctors that our system can match it. They thought it's a joke. This guy will never do what he's doing. But now we see he's doing it. When you look at the MRI of this gentleman, you see like his pieces of brain missing. And it's very interesting, in the next MRI, next week, what has been developed? What did we achieve? Is it ready?
Just 1 minute yet.
1 minute yet. And as I said, we see him now. We haven't updated this week yet. We see him now drawing, we see him now doing different activities. He's gradually taking a step up, and we go through the dilemma of up and down with an illness like this. The doctors are supervising it, we just provide the technology. Start.
Yeah, I'll play it here.
Mamy koniec tłumaczenia na dzisiaj, tak więc zapraszam, jeżeli ktoś chce zabrać głos.
Tradycyjnie zostałem w chwili ciszy. Postaram się przybliżyć tu parę kwestii, które było wspomnianych na tym warsztacie wytłumaczonych. Zaczęło się od tematu Red Circle, czyli całej działalności pedofilskiej. Tam była informacja, że fundacja została poproszona o to, żeby założyć stronę, gdzie będzie pomagać, namierzać właśnie takie przypadki, pomagać zbierać informacje w tym temacie. Także to, co się zaczęło kiedyś, poprzez to, że w fundacji były właśnie osoby związane właśnie z tym tematem. Teraz ta praca, to co zostało zrobione w przyszłości, zostało w pewien sposób można powiedzieć, wzięte pod uwagę i to zadanie też zostało powierzone, gdzieś została zaoferowana pomoc fundacji w tym temacie. Także to był pierwszy temat. Następnie mieliśmy taki wstęp w zasadzie do całości tego, co, o czym było później mówione, czyli jaka jest różnica między masą i wagą. Teraz wiemy, że masa, jak tutaj doktor Kesze tłumaczył, w Układzie Słonecznym wszędzie jest taka sama, a z kolei waga zależy już właśnie od tej inercji, czyli tej bezwładności, od interakcji siły pola środka z właśnie z inercją, czyli z tym stanem bezwładności środowiska, w którym jest masa, czyli można powiedzieć dusza, a waga to jest właśnie ta fizyczność, manifestacja w stosunku do danego środowiska. Później mieliśmy ten rysunek. Nie wiem, Jarku, czy mógłbyś go gdzieś tam rzucić na początku dość, jeszcze gdzieś około 50 minuty. Był ten rysunek, gdzie doktor Kesze pokazywał to, czego się też uczyliśmy, o czym mówią jego nauki, czyli jak właśnie z materii iść w stan nano, z tego stanu w GANS. I potem dochodzimy do takiego punktu, gdzie właśnie dzięki to, co było narysowane na czerwono, czyli właśnie z tego GANS-u możemy z powrotem iść w materię poprzez kreację, interakcję właśnie z polami materii. Myślę, że tutaj wracają na myśl te reaktorki, gdzie kiedyś właśnie były pokazywane, opisywane eksperymenty, w których właśnie następowała kreacja tej materii. I to jest ta, można powiedzieć, ta czerwona ścieżka, czyli tutaj gdzieś ten krąg się zamyka. Zaczynaliśmy od materii, kończymy z powrotem na materii. A z kolei druga ścieżka, którą tutaj mamy, druga opcja, można powiedzieć, to jest to, co mamy narysowane na niebiesko, czyli właśnie w kierunku duszy poprzez interakcję z polami wyższego rzędu. I co by tutaj jeszcze dodać w tym temacie? Jeszcze doktor Kesze mówi o w tym momencie, wrócił też do, nawiązał do tematu narodzin, gdzie odbywa się właśnie kreacja nowej energii wyższego rzędu niż fizyczność, z której pochodzi. Też w pewien sposób mamy opisany tutaj ten diagram, ten rysunek, mamy też opisany proces, można powiedzieć, narodzin, bo mamy tutaj też dwa elementy i tworzenia materii z materii i tworzenia właśnie z GANS-u, tworzenia tego aspektu właśnie naszej duszy, czyli mamy ten dualizm, o którym często doktor Kesze mówi i w zasadzie wszystko jest zawarte tutaj na tym rysunku, ale to nie jest jedyne, można powiedzieć, przesłanie, przynajmniej tak jak z tego, co zrozumiałem i odebrałem. Do tego też rysunku doktor Kesze pośrednio wracał w dalszej części nauczania, bo tłumacząc kolejne rzeczy, chociażby związane z tą jednostką wzmacniającą, plazmatyczną, kosmiczną, która jest ostatnio promowana i sprzedawana i słyszymy o tym, jakie jest jej działanie, to ta jednostka jest właśnie tym, co umożliwia, daje pewnego rodzaju wybór właśnie tej podróży fizyczności razem z duszą. I myślę, że tutaj mówiąc fizycznością, możemy się odnieść właśnie do tego, co później było mówione, czyli o duszy fizyczności, która może być zabrana razem z duszą. Teraz można tutaj pójść dalej i rozwinąć sobie ten temat. Więc skoro mamy te dwa elementy, duszę zabieramy i duszę fizyczności, czyli bierzemy, powiedzmy, Słońce i Ziemię, można tak porównać, które tworzy warunki właśnie dla aminokwasu, dla danego życia, dla danej manifestacji, tak samo jak te dwie dusze kreują w swoim balansie, w tym środowisku, w inercji tego, czyli w tej sile bezwładności tego stanu materii, w którym się znajdują, one kreują fizyczność, która jest właśnie odpowiednia dla tego środowiska. I teraz jeśli bierzemy dwa takie elementy, jesteśmy w stanie, z których właśnie kreuje się fizyczność, jesteśmy w stanie właśnie w tej podróży zamanifestować tą fizyczność właśnie w stosunku do tego, jak to się odbędzie w tym stanie bezwładności kolejnego środowiska, które wybieramy. Czyli można by tutaj też zadać takie pytanie, czy to są właśnie narodziny bez, znaczy manifestacja fizyczności bez tego aspektu narodzin. Tak jak tutaj widzimy, żebyśmy byli ludźmi, to musimy się narodzić, od noworodka przejść przez tą całą wędrówkę fizyczności, a z kolei przynajmniej tak odebrałem ten fragment, że właśnie to pozwala na coś, co myślę też w religii było nazywane niepokalanym poczęciem, czyli kreacją właśnie bez tego aktu fizyczności, czyli kreacją nie z fizyczności, tak jak mieliśmy tutaj rysowane, tylko właśnie kreacją z poziomu duszy, z poziomu manifestacji poprzez właśnie interakcję, tarcie, balansowanie się tych dwóch dusz. I tutaj o systemie doktor Keshe dalej mówi, że jest to takie jakby łono do posmakowania tego, okno, można powiedzieć, na wszechświat, na to, jak ten wymiar wygląda. Jest to też krok do przodu dla nas, jeśli chodzi o zrozumienie, dojście do tak jak mówimy, do tej elewacji, czyli do tego zniesienia, podniesienia naszego poziomu zrozumienia. I tak samo jak właśnie ten diagram wcześniejszy, który był rysowany, na nim było wyłapane to pokazane, gdzie właśnie obecność środowiska tworzy, warunkuje tą manifestację tego, co powstaje, tam też to było wymienione. I jeszcze jeśli chodzi o tą jednostkę, doktor Keshe mówił o tym, właśnie o tej świadomości, o tym wyborze, że to my możemy decydować, czy zostać przy fizyczności, i tą decyzję podejmujemy w pełnej świadomości naszej duszy. Tu można by sobie gdzieś też dopowiedzieć, że jeśli przed takim pytaniem stajemy, czy sami decydujemy, mamy ten wybór, to jeśli decyzja jest taka, że zostajemy na przykład przy tej fizyczności, wtedy ten stan fizyczny, z którym dana osoba wchodzi, jest, tak jak mówimy, to jest jednostka wzmacniająca, balansująca, więc jeśli decyzja jest taka, że to nie jest moment separacji jednej duszy od fizyczności, to być może dlatego też można to tak zrozumieć, że te choroby, te schorzenia balansują się z powrotem, cofają w związku z tym, jaka jest podjęta decyzja. I tutaj też takie pytanie, ile zaakceptujemy, czy będziemy, czego będziemy się wypierać w tym nowym wymiarze jako ludzkość, w tym nowym wymiarze zrozumienia, bo myślę, że tutaj doktor Keshe nawiązuje do tego, jaka jest właśnie tendencja, czy można powiedzieć natura ludzka do tego typu, tego rodzaju zachowań. I jeszcze taki tutaj był ciekawy aspekt tego, gdzie często porównujemy, właśnie patrzymy albo w mikro, albo w makro, obserwujemy to samo, i doktor Keshe mówi o tym, że w ciele nie ma takiej rotacji, jak obserwujemy to w tym właśnie świecie makro. Jeśli spojrzymy w gwiazdy obracające się wokół siebie, te wszystkie systemy słoneczne, planetarne i tak dalej, tak w przypadku ciała człowieka nie ma tej rotacji, ale tą funkcję spełnia właśnie cyrkulacja krwi, a bicie serca to jest właśnie tym przełącznikiem, który także decyduje o separacji właśnie tego aspektu fizyczności, bo wiemy, że jak serce przestaje bić, to ta fizyczność umiera, więc chociażby z tego
pod takim kątem można spojrzeć na to, jak na przełącznik. Później mieliśmy po raz kolejny doktor Kesz rysował tego naszego słynnego ślimaka, czyli tłumaczył tutaj, że właśnie plazma zawija się do środka, rośnie do środka, rośnie w siłę do środka, a nie na zewnątrz, tak jak jest to w przypadku wymiaru fizycznego. Ten wymiar fizyczny mamy do czynienia właśnie z ekspansją, z tym, że rośnie, tak jak my się rodzimy przecież, jako zaczynamy od jednej komórki, a później przybieramy coraz to większe rozmiary i w związku z tym, że ta fizyczność idzie na zewnątrz, dlatego tutaj doktor Kesze też mówi tak, nawiązuje do takiego powiedzenia, że urodziliśmy się po to, by umrzeć, dlatego że ta ekspansja, dzięki Jarku, to co widzimy po lewej, to jest rysowana ta ekspansja też ma swoje jakieś granice, bo jest pewnym cyklem, który zatacza krąg, dochodzi do punktu saturacji, można powiedzieć, nasycenia tego punktu balansu, w którym następuje właśnie odrzucenie, separacja od tej fizyczności. Z poziomu duszy rodzimy się, by rosnąć w siłę do poziomu duszy kreatora, czyli w kierunku środka, w kierunku tych silniejszych pól. Było też pytanie o to, czemu fizyczność nie topi się w momencie śmierci. Właśnie tłumaczył to, że dzieje się tak, bo jest częścią tego środowiska, zostaje tutaj w tym wymiarze, a nie opuszcza go na przykład razem z duszą. To pytanie o topienie, myślę, było w kontekście tego, co tych przykładów, które często doktor Kesze tłumaczy, że o tym cukrze, z rozpuszczaniu cukru w wodzie, że tak właśnie wygląda ta podróż, powiedzieć, to jest jak rozpuszczanie tego cukru i później w danym środowisku, danej planecie cukier to jest właśnie nawiązanie do reprezentacji fizyczności w tym wymiarze, a raczej duszy fizyczności, jeśli zrozumiemy ten sposób, tą pierwszą część wykładu. Później doktor Kesze mówił, wracał do tematu Brazylii, konferencji tam, do tego też, jakie było zamieszanie pewnego rodzaju kłamstwa od strony osób, które były zaangażowane z ramienia fundacji właśnie w organizowanie różnych rzeczy ze społecznością brazylijską. Wiadomo, to jest ten sam język, co język portugalski, więc tam były pewnego rodzaju historie, które akurat tutaj nie były w detalach poruszane. Później ten fragment zakończył nam się, tak jak oglądaliśmy, tą jednostką zdrowia miał lecieć akurat ten kawałek i o tym doktor Kesze mówi z powrotem, znaczy o tej jednostce wzmacniającej plazmatycznej, że te centra zdrowia powstają w różnych krajach. Mieliśmy wymieniane różne lokalizacje, była informacja o lekarzach, którzy będą zatrudniani po to, żeby 24 na dobę zapewniać wsparcie dla lekarzy, którzy będą obsługiwać te jednostki. Była mowa o próbach klinicznych, o zamówieniach, realizacji tych zamówień, różnego rodzaju liczby tam padały. No i po raz kolejny też było w przypadku Parkinsona i Alzheimera, który od paru tygodni oglądamy coraz to kolejne filmiki. Doktor Kesze mówi, że tak co drugi tydzień w zasadzie doklejają kolejne porcje wideo, na których pokazany jest postęp ostatnio na warsztacie, czyli 303 było powiedziane, że właśnie ten pan chyba nie bierze żadnych lekarstw. Tam było też nawiązanie do tego chłopca z epilepsją, który też, z tego co pamiętam, tam już nie było chyba żadnych lekarstw podawanych i w tym kontekście doktor Kesze mówi coraz więcej, coraz śmielej właśnie o tym aspekcie tego, jakie szkody wyrządzają te lekarstwa, które były brane w ilościach, także 407 na przykład tabletek dziennie przez tego chłopca albo przez tego pana z Alzheimerem i z Parkinsonem, bo to w tym przypadku mówimy właśnie o tych dwóch schorzeniach występujących jednocześnie i teraz, kiedy ten system wzmacniający, balansujący przywraca tą fizyczność do pierwotnego stanu, w pewien sposób cofa te schorzenia, które tam wystąpiły. po tej regeneracji, w trakcie tej regeneracji zaczynają właśnie wychodzić różnego rodzaju efekty uboczne właśnie tych wszystkich lekarstw, na co też zwraca uwagę, mówię o tym, że no, wcześniej to było w pewien sposób ukrywane, bo lekarstwami były karmione osoby właśnie z takim przewlekłym, nieuleczalnym wręcz schorzeniem, jeśli mówimy o tego rodzaju chorobach, i w zasadzie to był tylko droga w jednym kierunku, degeneracja tych jednostek, tych osób, które właśnie na takie schorzenia cierpią, więc taka osoba nie była w stanie w sposób, powiedzmy, jakiś na przykład przekonywujący wykazać, pokazać właśnie, jakie są efekty brania tego rodzaju lekarstw, które jak wiemy często posiadają więcej efektów ubocznych niż tego, na co tak naprawdę pomagają. No i to w zasadzie tyle, jeśli chodzi do tego momentu, jeśli ktoś ma coś do dodania ze swojego zrozumienia, albo chciałby poruszyć jakieś inne kwestie związane z technologią, z plazmą, to oczywiście zapraszam.
Przemku, mam jeszcze takie krótkie pytanie, bo tam był fragment taki na temat tłumaczeń poprzez Telegram jakiś, nie wiem, o co tam dokładnie chodziło, jaki to jest system. Wiesz coś na to?
Tak, tam były gdzieś linki, krążyły po internecie, ja muszę sobie zobaczyć, jak to się nazywa, może na następny wykład spróbuję sobie gdzieś z tym poeksperymentować i wtedy będę mógł powiedzieć z troszkę innej pozycji zrozumienia tego, o czym jest mowa, bo te linki gdzieś tam były przez Karolinę, przez parę jeszcze innych osób wrzucane, pamiętam, Yandex, czy jakoś tak, nie pamiętam nazwy tego, także szukam, sprawdzę, odpalę. Mowa była o jakiejś wtyczce, z tego co rozumiem, do Telegrama, czyli komunikatora takiego jak WhatsApp, tylko w przypadku WhatsAppa, z tego co pamiętam, to chyba Facebook jest właścicielem WhatsAppa, jeśli chodzi o Telegram, to była prywatna firma, gdzieś to Niemiec chyba sięga, gdzie ta firma istnieje i nie jest właśnie w posiadaniu żadnego z tych dużych gigantów, jak właśnie Google, Facebook, czy inne takie, posiada dobre funkcje właśnie szyfrowania, jeśli chodzi o aspekty bezpieczeństwa, ale w zasadzie funkcjonalność tej aplikacji jest identyczna jak WhatsApp i mowa tutaj była właśnie o wtyczce, która w czasie rzeczywistym tłumaczy z danego języka, którym jest mówione, na inny język, ale czy w przypadku tej wtyczki są pokryte wszystkie języki, możliwość tłumaczenia z każdego na każdy, czy ten zakres języków, który jest tam zimplementowany, jest, jak on jest szeroki, no to na to pytanie jeszcze nie mogę powiedzieć. Spróbuję zainstalować i wtedy coś w przyszłym tygodniu będę mógł więcej powiedzieć.
No dzięki, Przemku. Jakieś pytania jeszcze są? Lub ktoś chce coś dodać? Jeśli nie ma, to dziękuję za dzisiaj, za to, że byliście tutaj. Tak więc to były 313 warsztaty poszukiwaczy wiedzy w języku polskim z niedzieli 24 listopada 2019 roku. Tak więc do usłyszenia i spotykamy się w czwartek. Tak więc dobrej nocy.
Nadszedł czas zmiany, przejścia do prawdziwego działania wszechświata. I nadszedł czas, aby zrozumieć, że używamy stanu materii, by osiągnąć poziom zrozumienia duszy człowieka. Teraz rozumiesz, być może, dlaczego Kreator wysłał swoich posłańców w imię tego, co miałeś. To oni przynoszą uszy, aby można było ich użyć, gdy nadejdzie czas Mesjasza. Mogę nauczyć duszę i przesłanie. Nie by się przeciwstawiać, ale poprzez ich zrozumienie, przez tych, którzy stali się Mesjaszami, aby dawać ze swoich dusz, aby ich elewować. Zadanie stało się łatwe. Szkoła jest tutaj i uczniowie są tutaj w oddaniu. Wtedy nie będzie żadnej walki między tym, co nazywają muzułmanami a chrześcijanami. Baranek i lew będą jeść i spać w tym samym gnieździe. Chrześcijanie i muzułmanie będą spać i modlić się w meczecie, w tym samym kościele, w imię ich dusz, nie w imię religii, które są używane do tworzenia tak wielu konfliktów, dla korzyści tych, którzy byli hiperaktywnymi dziećmi. Nadszedł czas, czas zmian jest tutaj. I jak powiedziałem, moje życzenie jest moim rozkazem. Jeśli pragniesz ujrzeć pokój, droga pokoju jest wyłożona bardzo wyraźnie. To dusza świadomości zbiorowej. Poprzez dawanie stworzy tą pozycję zmiany. Nic innego. W duszy człowieka nie ma długopisu. Jestem pewien, że po wejściu do społeczności uniwersalnej nigdy nie zobaczysz niczego zapisanego, ale równowagę pól duszy egzystencji. Staraj się być na tyle pokornym, aby nie stać się aroganckim w mocy, którą zrozumiałeś i posiadłeś. Inaczej wpadniesz w tą samą ścieżkę kościoła i meczetu. To jest to, co obiecaliśmy i to właśnie dostarczyliśmy. Musimy zrozumieć działanie duszy i musimy zrozumieć, że dusza człowieka jest gwiazdą w kosmosie wszechświata. Jeśli porównamy duszę człowieka i tak wielu nas, 7 miliardów w jednym zbiorze, Ziemia jest jak galaktyka z tak wieloma gwiazdami. Kiedy patrzymy w głąb wszechświata, widzimy galaktyki z setkami milionów gwiazd. Podobnie jest z planetą Ziemią. Niesie 7 miliardów pięknych gwiazd, które są duszą człowieka. Niesie z sobą duszę tak wielu trylionów zwierząt, roślin i wszystkiego innego. Jeśli więc patrzą ci, którzy nie widzą fizyczności Ziemi i jej zawartości, co widzą? Widzą galaktykę z wielką ilością pięknych, świecących świateł. Każda według swojej siły. Każda zgodnie ze swoją pozycją. Niemowlę ma piękną duszę, podobnie jak staruszek. Dla tych niefizycznych, którzy nie widzą fizycznego wymiaru tej planety, ale widzą siłę pola, jesteśmy gromadami gwiazd. Ludzka rasa, każda pojedyncza dusza, nikt z daleka nie widzi. To jest dusza rybaka, to jest dusza kosmologa, to jest dusza prezydenta. Wszystkie świecą bez względu na fizyczność. To jest magia. Oto co nowa nauka musi przynieść człowiekowi. Kiedy patrzymy przez naszą duszę, widzimy tylko gwiazdy w innych duszach. I to jest przełom. To jest zrozumienie. Na tym właśnie polegają te wszystkie nauki. Dojście do dojrzałości następnego poziomu, aby zrozumieć daleki kosmos. Wszechświat jest ostrygą dla tych dusz, które służą. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy do wejścia w kosmos. Wtedy człowiek jest gotowy, aby stać się częścią uniwersalnej społeczności, która została obiecana. Nigdy nie obiecywałem wam nieba. Zawsze obiecywałem wam elewację człowieka, aby przyłączył się do rodziny. A teraz macie klucz. To wy musicie otworzyć drzwi, aby zrozumieć, że mogę elewować duszę tych ludzi lub milionów innych dusz, że fizyczne życie na tej planecie zmieni się. Wtedy jestem godny bycia częścią społeczności uniwersalnej, by być, aby służyć, aby się rozwijać, by być tam, aby być częścią, że w cyklu życia Wszechświata staje się w byciu częścią, staje się częścią totalności. Kiedy człowiek osiągnie ten punkt, pojawi się nowy wymiar w sile duszy człowieka, który jest poza wyobrażeniem zrozumienia życia fizycznego. To jest brama do otwarcia nowego życia w nowym wymiarze, co jest poza wyobrażeniem tego, co mogliście nazwać nowym początkiem, nowym cyklem, gdzie ten cykl niesie ze sobą źródło stworzenia życia we Wszechświecie i Unikosie. To jest elewacja duszy, aby służyć, stała się kluczem. Nie tron życia fizycznego. Czas jest odpowiedni, nadszedł czas, aby człowiek przeszedł przez ten proces.